President Vladimir Putin testing a new intercontinental missile and President Donald Trump's medal. From a Moscow command center, Putin watched the hypersonic missile leave its launch tube and, according to the Russians, strike a target 3,700 miles away, declaring it invulnerable to intercept.
Will Russia's new hypersonic missiles rule the world? Imagine waking up to the news that Russia has just sent jets armed with the world's most advanced missiles to patrol a region brimming with geopolitical tensions. This became a reality on October 18, 2023, when Russian President Vladimir Putin ordered fighter jets equipped with hypersonic missiles to commence 24/7 patrols over the Black Sea. This move by Russia has been widely seen as a significant escalation of tensions between Russia and the West, particularly in light of the ongoing war in Ukraine. But why exactly hypersonic missiles? And why has the world gone mad on Russia's move to send hypersonic missiles to patrol the strategic Black Sea? There are two main types of hypersonic missiles: hypersonic glide vehicles, HGVs, and hypersonic cruise missiles, HCMs. HGVs are launched by a rocket booster and then glide through the atmosphere at hypersonic speeds. HCMs are powered by a ramjet or scramjet engine and fly at hypersonic speeds throughout their flight. Unlike traditional ballistic missiles, which typically travel at Mach 20 to 25, hypersonic missiles can travel at a much faster speed of Mach 5 or higher, over 6,174 kilometers per hour. In the context of the Black Sea, which spans approximately 1,175 kilometers at its widest point, a missile could traverse that distance in mere minutes. Now, let's put this into perspective. Imagine a missile traveling from Los Angeles to New York in about 30 minutes. That's the kind of speed we're talking about with hypersonic missiles. But it's not just their speed that's impressive. It's also their incredible range. These missiles can cover several thousand kilometers, making them formidable in any region. This rapid reach drastically shortens the reaction time of opposing forces and escalates the potential for sudden, impactful strikes. This changes the entire strategic game, making the Black Sea a regional playground and a stage for showcasing some of the most advanced military technology. So, what does this mean for patrolling the Black Sea? Well, with hypersonic missiles, distances that once seemed vast are now quickly within reach. Moreover, these missiles can maneuver mid-air, making them difficult to intercept. Yes, you heard it right. These missiles aren't just fast, they are also highly agile. Hypersonic missiles can maneuver mid-flight, unlike traditional ballistic missiles, which follow a predictable arc, altering their trajectory and altitude. This ability makes them exceedingly difficult to intercept. For instance, current missile defense systems are designed to track and target objects moving along a predictable path. But the erratic movement of hypersonic missiles poses a significant challenge. And when it comes to warheads, you won't believe it, but these special hypersonic missiles can carry conventional, nuclear, and chemical warheads, all the variety at once within it. This versatility presents a complex challenge for defense strategists. For example, the decision-making process in responding to a hypersonic missile threat becomes complicated when the type of warhead is unknown. This uncertainty adds a layer of complexity to military strategy, as the response must be calibrated to the potential risk. So the power Russia might get is as unchallenged as it seems to you and me? I know you might be wondering why Russia is so heavily investing in modern warfare all of a sudden and deploying these formidable weapons in the Black Sea. There are several unhidden theories that we are going to reveal to you. Introducing hypersonic missiles into the Black Sea region alters the strategic landscape. It effectively turns the area into a highly contested zone where military supremacy can be demonstrated. Countries bordering the Black Sea, like Ukraine, Russia, and Turkey, must now consider these new threats in their defense planning. The presence of these missiles also serves as a deterrent, making adversaries think twice before engaging in direct conflict due to the high risk of rapid and severe retaliation. So, it could be a bold message to the West, signaling readiness to deploy advanced military weapons in a potential conflict due to tensions between Russia and other countries. Alternatively, it might be a deterrent against NATO's involvement in the Russia-Ukraine war. NATO, a group of countries including the USA and many from Europe, is closely watching the war in Ukraine. By sending these missiles, Russia could be trying to scare NATO and stop them from getting involved in the Russia-Ukraine war. It's like a strong message saying, stay out of this, or we might use these missiles. With a range exceeding 1,000 kilometers and speeds up to Mach 9, the Kinzhal hypersonic missile is a formidable weapon to counter enemies. Its deployment in the Black Sea means it can target any location in the region, including NATO member states. Understanding the broader implications of this strategic placement by Russia is crucial. This leap in military technology brings a host of new strategic considerations and potential implications for future war. Yes, it's that serious. Let's delve deeper and see some of its implications. Hypersonic missiles, being very fast and maneuverable, become difficult to track and intercept. This increases the risk of a miscalculation or accident that could lead to a conflict between Russia and the West. For example, if a Russian hypersonic missile were to malfunction or be misidentified, it could be mistakenly shot down by NATO forces. This could lead to a spiral of escalation, resulting in a full-blown conflict in the world. The Black Sea, where Russia has shown its unchallenged power, is a strategically important region for NATO. It is home to several NATO member states, including Romania and Bulgaria. NATO also has a number of military bases in the region. Russia's deployment of hypersonic missiles to the Black Sea makes it more difficult for NATO to operate in the region. Hypersonic missiles could be used to target NATO ships and aircraft, making them more vulnerable. This could deter NATO from operating in the Black Sea region, giving rise to geopolitical tension between NATO and Russia, which would destroy the world. The question then arises, how will these nations respond to such a display of power? And what does this mean for the fragile balance of power in the region? Well, a race to develop cutting-edge technologies to counter these ultra-fast missiles has been started. The U.S. is not sitting idle. Let's delve deeper to look at counter-strategies it is developing to compete with one of its biggest enemies. They're crafting new sensors that sound like something from a sci-fi movie. This high technology includes ground radars, space sensors, and even airborne trackers. The U.S. is also developing new sensors to detect the heat signature of hypersonic missiles. In addition, it is developing new interceptors to shoot down the missiles. These are called missile hunters. Think of these as the guardians in the sky. The U.S. is working on interceptors that can be launched from the ground, air, and sea. Imagine a missile that can chase down and destroy a hypersonic missile mid-flight. And there's more. Laser-based interceptors are also in the works, adding a futuristic twist to this high-stakes game. It has also simultaneously invested in the development of directed energy weapons. We're talking about high-powered microwaves and lasers capable of disabling or even annihilating hypersonic missiles. Here's where it gets even more intriguing. In addition to developing new technologies, the U.S. is working with its allies to develop a coordinated response to the hypersonic missile challenge. The U.S. and its allies are conducting joint exercises to train their forces to detect, track, and engage hypersonic missiles. They are also sharing intelligence and developing standard operating procedures. Here are some specific examples of U.S. programs to develop hypersonic missile countermeasures. Hypersonic Defense Interceptor, HDI. The HDI program is developing a new ground-based missile that will be able to intercept hypersonic missiles. It is expected to be deployed in the early 2030s. The DESEND, Directed Energy for Strategic Competition, program is developing a new high-energy laser system that will be able to disable or destroy hypersonic missiles. The DESEND system is also expected to be deployed in the mid-2030s. Let's explore more facts about hypersonic missiles that will surely surprise you. These super-fast missiles are a big deal for countries like the United States, Russia, and China, and they're spending a lot of money on them. Did you know Russia was the first to create a hypersonic missile? This happened way back in the 1980s, when it was still called the Soviet Union. Since then, Russia hasn't been playing around with this technology. They've put a massive $5 billion into their hypersonic missile program just in 2023. While Russia was the one to initiate, The U.S. joined this high-speed race in the 1990s. Their coolest hypersonic missile is the Hypersonic Glide Vehicle, HGV, and it's no slouch either. The United States is investing $4.7 billion in its hypersonic missile program. They're serious about keeping up and ensuring they have some of the fastest missiles in the world. But the advancements in hypersonic missile technology by Russia and the US aren't just a matter of national security for these countries, they have global implications. For example, their initiatives have pushed other countries to start or accelerate their own hypersonic programs. China, for instance, is also a key player in this arena, having demonstrated significant advancements in hypersonic technology with plans to take over Russia in this technology in the next decade. With too much investment comes the risk of greater geopolitical tension in the world, and we can hear whispers of tension leading to another potential war in the coming era. Curious to know about modern military warfare and its implications more? Hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay with us to get the most recent updates and insights about the world from us.